president for the world. He could not defile the sanctity of the Holy Kaaba. He said, I will not stay in the city that is so sacred that if my blood falls over here, it will harm the sanctity of this Haram. He left Makkah. He also left Makkah for another reason. There was a city in the north called Kufa. And the people of Kufa, who as I pointed out earlier, were overwhelmingly Shia, they sent him letters. Not one letter, not two letters, not three letters. It's written in the books that there were sacks full of letters being received from Kufa, and all of those letters said just one thing: Imam Hussain, come back to Kufa, come to Kufa, we will elect you the king, we will the Khalifa, we will elect you the Khalifa, and we will fight under your banner, we will sacrifice our lives for you, Imam, come to Kufa quickly. They said something more. They said, if you do not come to Kufa at the day of judgment, Ya Imam, we will hold you liable and accountable that we asked for Hidayat and the Imam did not come to give us Hidayat. And Imam Hussain went to Karbala, went to Kufa. And I think Imam Hussain did a brilliant job, because from that point till today and from this point till Qiyamah, now nobody can be a Kufi and say, Imam, we called you and you didn't come to help us out, because Imam has set a precedent. Ali Shariati, when the revolution in Iran took place, it was because Ali Shariati reintroduced this concept. He said something that I want you to hear as well. He said, Kullu yawmin Ashura, wa kullu aradin Karbala, wa kullukum al-Husayn. Every day, Kullu yawmin, every day is like the day of Ashura. It is a battle between good and evil. Kullu aradin Karbala, every place in the world is Karbala. It is a place where you need to sacrifice what you want in favor of what is right. وَكُلُّكُمْ الْحُسَيْنِ. Each and every one of you is Hussain. You are all Hussain. You are all Hussain. In your day-to-day life, you are Hussain. Imam Hussain has set that precedent. Imam Hussain then responds to the letters of the Kufans. He sends his ambassador to Kufa, and then he starts traveling himself as well. But he knows he's not traveling for war. He travels with a select few companions. He travels with his family and he heads towards Kufa. On the way, he's intercepted and he's told that the Kufans have ditched, to use the modern word, the word that we use. The Kufans have ditched and the Kufans have been taken over by Yazid's army, and you are supposed to be, you're redirected. And Imam was redirected from Kufa towards the river. So he was in such a position where there's the river on one side and the enemy then encircles them near Kufa at a city called Karbala. If I start explaining all the Masayib in all their details, particularly in the English language, which is harder for us to empathetically relate to, it's going to take too much time. I'm going to pass on the torch, because it's not my ability. It is not my place to be able to recite with justice the Masayib, the problems that were faced by the Imam. My job now will just be to explain to you the story, and as the story moves on, we will have Marcia Khans come and they will recite. Well, Marcia ke liye aap jo hai unko bulana shuru kar dein, jinka pehla Marcia hai. Imam has left for Kufa. Imam does not reach Kufa. Instead, he reaches the battlefield of Karbala. Karbala is a hot, barren land, so barren that nothing grew there. There are people who said it was Nineveh. There are people who said it was a cursed land. And it was a place where the heat was unbearable. And it is Hussain who settled there, surrounded by the enemies. And you see story after story. Charisma after charisma of the Imam. And Imam-e-Waqt is such a beautiful personality that the more you think about him, the more beauties you see in the Imam. When the Imam reaches Karbala, it is the second of Muharram. Imam reaches Karbala on the second of Muharram. He reaches Karbala, he settles and he camps over there, and he sees that the armies have started arriving. The first army that arrived was the army led by a person called Hur. And that army was thirsty, they didn't have water. So the Imam said, give them all the water that we have, because we need to show them that this is our kirdar, this is who we are. We are the ones that when we see somebody asking for water, we do not deny them water. What a pity. What a pity there was this Imam. What a pity there was this Imam who, less than 9 days later, would be martyred of 3 days of thirst, after 3 days of thirst. Imam camps at Karbala. There are a few people that are with him. For those of you who volunteers, aap log please kuch log idhar line bana ke baith jaye. Aap nishan aap idhar baithe raho, baaki kuch volunteers idhar line bana ke baith jaye. Koi wahan se hamla shamla hota hai to aap uska muqabla kar sake na. Ladke idhar baith jao. Acha, idhar hi ho sab. Jaag rahe ho? Naray takbir. Naray risalat. Naray Haydari. Naray salawat. Karbala mein imam do tareek ko pahunch gaye, khur ko pani pila diya, khaime laga diye, sabse beech mein khaima lagaya, khawateen ke khaimon ke beech mein khaima lagaya nabi ki nawasiyon ka, kyunki wo nabi ki nawasiyan hain. Aur apne isko apne level pe empathize karo na. Aap mein se gharon mein khawateen hain na sabke, गुस्सा भी आ जाता है अगर बाहर वो बाजार में जाए उनको कोई छेड़े, गुस्सा आता है एकदम से, गैरत जागती है, मर्दाना गैरत जागती है. ये हमारे घर की खवातीन है, इनकी तरफ कोई देखे भी ना, वो हमारे घर की खवातीन है और हम कहते हैं इनकी तरफ कोई देखे भी ना, ये नबी के घर की खवातीन है. इनके लिए खैमा लगता है बीच में, आस पास बाकी खवातीन के खैमे लगते हैं, उसके बाद बाकी लोगों के खैमे लगते हैं, एक तरफ एक खंदक एक डिच खोदते हैं ताकि वहां से हमला ना हो सके, बाकी साइड के ऊपर पहरा देते हैं. एक एक करके दिन गुजरते जाते हैं. 5 मुहर्रम को इनको हुक्म होता है कि आप दरिया से अपने खैमों को दूर कर लें. 6 मुहर्रम को इनके खैमों में पानी खत्म हो जाता है. 7 को कहते हैं कि एक कतरा भी पानी मौजूद नहीं था. खैमों में कौन कौन है? खैमों में हुसैन है, खैमों में हुसैन के भाई अब्बास हैं, खैमों में हुसैन की बहन जैनब है, खैमों में हुसैन की बेटी सकीना है, खैमों में हुसैन का बेटा अली अकबर है और खैमों में हुसैन का बेटा अली असगर है. पूरा कुंबा नबी का खैमों में मौजूद है. यजीद की फौज आसपास लश्कर बना के खड़ी है. अरब के जो मसायब होते जाते हैं वो मसायब एक एक करके आप लोग सुनते जाए. अब की रात जो है, आज की रात जो है, उसमें जो बात करनी थी वो कर ली, जो किस्सा सुनाना था सुना दिया, जो गुजारिश करनी थी वो कर दी. आगे बढ़ो और हुसैन के आलम को थामो, हुसैन को अपनी जिंदगी में अपनाओ, हुसैन से सीखो और हुसैन के गम को दिलों में बसाओ. और उसके बाद अब के मसाइब जो है वो शुरू हो रहे हैं. एक एक करके मर्सिया खान आएंगे और मर्सिया पेश करते जाएंगे.
बाबा से बुलंद तर सलाम.
अल्लाहुम्मा सल्ली अला मोहम्मद व आली मोहम्मद.
के ही थी उठ जा मेरी जान में सकीना, माँ के उठ जा मेरी जान सकीना, उठ घर को चले खुल गया जिंदान सकीना, कहती थी उठ जा मेरी जान सकीना, बूंदे जो तेरे चादर तेरे सर पे उड़ा दूं, घर जाने कब अब हो गया सामान सकी.
आप लोग भी गौर से सुनते रहे और मैं गौर से बताता क्या। अब मर्जी के लिए साजिद बख्तियारी साहब आएंगे, ये इस इमाम बारगाह के जामिन हैं और मशहूर मर्जिया खान हैं, मर्जिया पढ़ने के लिए आ रहे हैं। साजिद बख्तियारी साहब बुलंदर सलावात।
मेरा खुश हो गया जनाब सकीना सलाम अल्लाह सलाम
अल्लाहुम्म सल्ले अला मोहम्मद व अली मोहम्मद
जिंदा
Oh, my God.